Hello. This time I looked at features that canonical offer to integrate Linux into more corporate environments which use AD. This video divided into three parts. Canonical has created AdmX file for Ubuntu and AdSys tool on clients, but all this required license. Ubuntu Pro subscriptions also got other features like landscape etc. So I copied from GitHub those AdmX and AdML files to AD server. Next copy those files into the policy definitions folder. You might need to create a policy definitions folder. Also, create that NS folder where put the AdML file. Now group policies have those Ubuntu policies. Next, we can open the GPO editor and looks at those Ubuntu policies. Ubuntu settings are under the administrative template. Let's configure sudo permissions, so we can use AD account to all tasks which required sudo permissions. I noticed that the most important requirement for all of this working is properly working DNS settings and servers. So make sure that at least Ubuntu clients have AD domain information on the host's file. Basic AD login required that package and later we add sssd plus Kerberos tools to our client. This client has DHCP from AD server, so DNS should be fine. Verify that the add domain can be found via DNS. Looks like the AD domain is found through Discover, so let's join this host to the AD. There are two options to join the client on AD with a specified user and OU or just default join with the administrator user. As normal, joining AD required admin permissions on AD. During this process, Ubuntu configures sssd.conf file, but I will add a few extra parameters that configure next. I have added these configuration file settings for offline login, maintaining account credentials offline for 14 days, and keeping Kerberos available offline. If you have some services which use AD credentials to log in, you can configure Kerberos to use this login method on the Ubuntu client. Let's add that AdSys and Kerberos to the client. To Kerberos configure, we can also add those abilities to work offline and cache file location for each user. Check that Kerberos configure files have proper file access permissions, like this one. If your AD account can't open programs on an Ubuntu client, you need to allow programs to read your home directories from a different location. Like example, I would have my AD user's home folder location like home/domain/user and prevent example Firefox to start. Then configure PAM to create home folders for AD users when they log in the first time to the Ubuntu client. Also, this needs to copy on a common account file with little change on the mask. Change the mask on the command account file. After reloading SSSD and Realm service, you can log into Ubuntu client with add credentials. At this point, we need to Ubuntu Pro subscription token. I attach this client to Ubuntu Pro with UA command. I enable those SSSD and Realm services, then we can reload the host and test login to the system with add credentials. Sometimes everything won't go as the plan. If the host ain't able to download GPO, check that DNS works, and also you can add on SSSD configuration with line add GPO access control permissive. Then reload SSSD service and retry load group policies from AD. Now connections between add and client work without issues. Now we can log in with add credentials. So our GPO effects on sudo on the terminal, but also GUI sudo permissions elevation. Thanks for watching, and see you soon.